I started to have power when I was 12 years.
Mm-hmm.
When I was 14 years, I remember God gave me tongues to kill someone.
God gave you tongues. Is it an instruction you're saying?
Yeah, God gave me tongues. God said, Nancy language was irritated and someone will die. If you want to curse someone, if you want to kill someone, this is a language that you must speak.
So there are aspects of my life that I will never reveal, that are between myself, my family.
And we became who we are because of that past and that history. Mm. We became strong women because we know who we are.
Our fundis and all of that, I mean, I heard the audible voice of God.
It wasn't the decision.
On the bed.
That one, yeah.
Like Christ himself.
What was that about?
I don't even know.
So you can't just trust the person who was able to initiate a relationship with your husband knowingly and trust them with your life, with your kid.
A fancy restaurant in a beautiful place in South Africa, and he left you with 7,000.
Love them. Boots, babe. He's not circumcised.
I meant our sex.
I mean, okay. I already do like that.
Yes.
Will it marry what you say you're doing? Which is...
The show is Engineer Your Life, and I'm Lungelo KM. It's another episode. I'm excited today because the type of guest we have is something that we've never had before on this channel. He's a prophet, and what I understand about prophecy is that it involves elevating into a spiritual realm that maybe some of us cannot understand. But Prophet Kwazi Maman is going to explain to us in a very detailed manner, and we'll get to understand ukuthi why a man of his stature has chosen to be able to connect to God and serve the people of South Africa in the manner that he's serving them. Prophet Kwazi Mamane, good morning, good afternoon, how are you?
Good man of God, kunjani?
Ngithi afternoon, morning, ngoba if you are ngazi zobuka nini, so yeah, izoyithatha ngendlela ethatha ngayo. Good to have you here, man.
Ngiyavuya kakhulu, man of God. Thank you
for inviting. Who is Prophet Kwazi Mamane? I'm very intrigued because logo sikubona in the media versus the person that is on this chair namhlanje could be a totally different person. I know it's a difficult question, yeah. Who are you? But when ungasibeka as who?
I always say ndingokunde ukwazi ukhulela eBizana.
Yeah.
Was born and raised in Bizana. I started calling them when I was 12 years. 12 years.
Yeah.
I've been doing it until now.
How do you believe or recognize Ugutune calling at the age of 12?
I think for me it was easy because umakhuluam, she was a prophet. So ekhaya kwakunecawa. So every day besisiye ecaweni, 5 o'clock ekuseni, 3 o'clock emini sisecaweni. But for me, iqale ngokungibamba esikolweni where I started to see izinto zabanye abantwana, when I started to see izinto zotishala, when I behaved different kwabanye abantwana. Then luckily there was someone owayekwazi ukungiguida athi mntanam, don't worry, even if esikolweni ukhona izinto ozibonayo, even if you find challenges ukuyodlala nabanye abantwana, ubona izinto ezingabonwa, you are different, we understand. So understand that uNkulunkulu une-purpose yobomi bakho. Then I was like, ithini the purpose? Of course, when you are young, you will be frustrated. But why am I different? Why am I impilo ngafana nabanye abantwana? I mean, brothers, they go to school, they are fine, abanayo le headache nginayo, xa befika esikolweni akho nto bayibonayo. I'm just ebusuku angilali, I'm seeing things, we understand. So luckily, and I thank God for that, because uNkulunkulu sent umakhulu wam to guide me and to make sure that I identify my gift and I follow it and I respect it until now.
Why then umakhulu doesn't identify the gift via African spirituality and amadlozi athi kuwena, no, rather go the church route? Why do you think yena may identify a gift, wayibona kanjalo?
Look, because she was a prophet,
okay.
And again, I always say to people, I didn't start as a prophet. I've never met any prophet then.
Okay.
Prophet
exposed.
I was never been exposed to prophets.
So
in the prophet,
yeah.
But wow, kukhona umprofeti maybe you understand mm-hmm. but mna I knew uba amayeza ngiyawazi ayekho inhlobo yomthi engingayaziyo I knew uba I can mix yonke into ngesandla sami nginike umuntu imsize I knew uba ngingathandazela umuntu izinto zenzeke but I couldn't identify myself find myself and give a name kwi-calling yami okay you're a prophet uyinyanga uyintoto but I knew because bekukhona iyinyanga eyikhona elalini and they will come to me I will help them
yeah.
you know
yeah.
so into ebengiyazi uba angiyiyinyanga anguye umthandazeli my gift is beyond that
sure.
you understand
sure.
because I and even now I found my gift but I haven't found the core of my gift mm-hmm. you understand I'm learning in the spirit
as
every day I'm finding myself in the spirit
sure.
wherever I'm promoted in the realms every day
sure.
but when I say to people I'm an African prophet
yeah.
African spiritualist I'm saying look at ngibheke ngelihlo of being an African
yeah.
because whatever that I'm dealing with whatever that I'm prophesying it whatever spirit that I'm fighting ngisilwa
sure.
as an African child
sure.
you understand
sure.
even the solutions zam ebantwini ziye emntwini omnyama
yeah.
you understand
yeah.
because yona ndweng exposed kuyo
sure.
I'm connected with ancestors I'm connected with spirit
would you say then a lot of spirituality so, the West has tried to remove Africa from it and that's why when uti I'm bringing back Africa into spirituality
look I believe man of God ukuba umuntu omnyama kusafuneka zifumane
sure
especially whoever that is in control of your spirituality mm-hmm. is in control of your life and thina abantu abamnyama we are not in control of our life abelungu basibambile basitshintsha basenza sabheka inkolo yethu as something that is demonic
or beneath
and
yeah.
and beneath you check umuntu omnyama immediately kuthi umuntu uyinyanga you already uyambuzo so ne ID yokuba kayanga esikolweni
uyangcola
uyangcola uyathini
yeah.
uyathini
yeah.
and also nathi siyayimosha
yeah.
inkolo yethu
yeah.
you understand but ikho yethu isekuthini we try to find ourselves eBhayibhelini you understand and inkolo yethu was never founded kwiBhayibheli kuba sizozifumana eBhayibhelini thina singabantu bakwamoya ifu sifuna ukuzifumana kufuneke sizile umoya siconnecte nendalo siconnecte nemvelo because singabantwana bomgquba singabantwana bemvelo so I always say to people xa ngithetha nabo ngithi ena as much of it's good to read the Bible but don't want to find yourself there
sure.
because you may miss it until God reveals yourself until you find you will be able to find your God and uNkulunkulu wakho will connect through indalo will connect through spirituality so into yenza thina abantu abamnyama sisilahle spirit sethu which when I say to people I'm an African prophet umzekelo I always especially to Christian when I say I'm an African prophet then mm-hmm. one will say why do you call yourself an African prophet it sounds very demonic
mm-hmm.
when I say to people I believe kumakadosha who is my grandmother I believe as my angel one will say why can't you go straight to God why do you need someone to usher you to God and I said they in the spiritual realm you don't just enter you come by invitation
okay
there is no way that you can just wake up and go to the spirit
mm-hmm.
someone must invite you must be ushered to enter in the spirit and I was ushered by my grandmother that's why every time when I'm given a platform like this I recognize her because I know she's my angel I know that kunezimpa zilwayo in dimensions in the spirit engekafiki kuzo kunezinto engizidefeatile by igrace yakhe engingakhange ngikwazi ukulwa nayo because yena sengilwela
born again believers bathi bona God is within us.
Yes.
uNkulunkulu uyamkhuleka noma ikephi whether you're in the shower or semotweni you can speak to God. Jesus paid the price.
Yes.
So why aren't you conflating that idea when by saying to me I need an ancestor in the form of your grandmother to invite me to God?
Now look, man of God, Jesus paid the price for us to believe that yonke into esiyenzayo kukhona uNkulunkulu. Now understand that in the realm of the spirit there are angels that ascend for us and each generation God sent umuntu wakhe to deliver that generation. Mm-hmm. And uNkulunkulu uzobonakala emntwini. And uNkulunkulu is too big for us ukuba sisimfake ebhotileni sithi and this is the way kaNkulunkulu and ayikho enye indlela.
Sure.
And I always say to people, God is not a Christian.
Christianity is man-made.
Christianity is man-made.
Yeah, the religion but part.
The religion yeah. part. And yeah. and angifumaneki with religion.
Okay.
I'm not a religious person.
Okay.
That's why if kukhona inhlombe yezangoma, I'm there. If kukhona inhlombe, wherever emzini, I'm there. Because I'm not a person with religion. I'm a spiritual person. I believe in the spirit. I go in the realm of the spirit. I see things beyond time. Mm-hmm. You understand? So I'm not a person omfumana with religion and say, if religion eat, then I must follow that.
Yeah.
You understand?
Yeah.
So whoever, and again, in Alendo Xindiso, it's something that maybe one day we should explain to people. Mm-hmm. But in Xindiso, and whoever come with it, what was their purpose for us? You understand? Because we can only defeat these things by talking about it, by letting our people understand yokwenza, find your own journey kuNkulunkulu. Uzokwazi ukuthola yourself, uzokwazi ukuthola ingilosi yasekhaya. Now you find abantwini but they go to church.
Mm-hmm.
But they aba support bazali babo. They go to church, they don't recognize izinto zakwabo. If uYesu wenza isiko lakwabo at age of 8 years, who are you not to do it? You understand? So now we need to explain to, because we are owing our kids to explain this thing, because whoever ungazazi ba usukaphi, man of God, akazuzazi uyaphi. That is why today you will see many churches everywhere you go.
Yeah.
You see a new church, but calamity is everywhere.
Yeah.
So yeah. That means there is a problem.
I angifuna udlule kakhulu in saying that we should unpack what Intsindiso is and who brought Intsindiso to Africa. What is your definition of what being born again is and maybe how it has been distorted? Like indlela esiyona manje, is it packaged correctly or isisephutheni elikhulu?
Hey, man of God, abekho abantu abakhohlakele njengabantu uthi bangama born again. And I believe okokuba ilento okuthiwa insindiso awuyonto oyithethayo, into oyiphilayo.
Sure.
You know?
Actions.
And awukwazi ukuthi usindisiwe ungakhanga ugqithe entweni efanele ukuba uzosindiswa kuyo. You must face certain things for you to reach the insindiso ekhuluma ngayo. And
yeah.
we must not hear it, we must see it. We understand. So and I don't believe really me as umamane yokuba ena many people bayiyo lento bathi bayiyo. We understand.
Yeah.
And for me, if usayithetha awukayiphile, then ayikho ngaphakathi kuwe. And again, a lot of people, they talk about uNkulunkulu, but they have never met him.
Isn't this so real, prophet? Is it real? Is it real that when you accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, you enter a new dimension of being perpetually forgiven? You live under a life of grace and peace. And then obviously, njengoba usho ama actions akho, then fanele sikubone ukuthi umuntu osindisiwe.
No, look, igama elithi insindiso li real emehlweni of those who believe in it. But those who don't believe in it, ababelieve ukuba umveli nqange wezisa uYesu ukuba ena thina sikholwe sibe nendlela elungileyo. Because for me, immediately uthi usindisiwe, then you are saying kukhona izinto engafunekanga zenzeke ebomini bakho.
Okay.
You understand? Then it means now you look life different kwabanye abantu.
Yeah.
Now I always say to people, where do usindisiwe? Whether usindiswanga, because insindiso it's just a gama, anyone can say usindisiwe. You understand? But phila impilo yobungcwele, phila impilo yokwazana noThixo necreator yakho. And iBhayibhile itsho kahle ubuThixo wakho emhlabeni ngumzali wakho. We understand.
Sure.
Kukhona izibusiso okufuneke uyifumane, kukhona iangels ofuneka uzirecognize ezasekhaya. Uqala kufuneke usindiswe ekhaya, usindise abantu basekhaya. You understand? So immediately, usindiswe ngaphandle, then there's a problem. And a lot of people, basindiswe ngaphandle, we see them outside more than a car. You understand? Kanti ufuna uqala ube ngumsindisi, which is wonke umuntu xa ezalwa, uzalwa abe ngumsindisi. Xa evela, bathi abazali bakhe, simchola umsindisi ozosusa enhluphekweni, simchola umsindisi ozozisa izinto ezintsha. You understand? So it doesn't necessarily mean you must go to church for you uze ube umsindisi.
Sure.
You understand? Uwe uba nguye umsindisi even if you don't go to church.
Mm-hmm.
Because uNkulunkulu akafinyelwa ecaweni. He's everywhere. You understand? But the Christian people, the religious people, they've made it a point of saying to our people, if you don't go to church, you are demonic. If you don't go to church, these are things. Who said that? You understand? So I'm saying, if uNkulunkulu ngowethu sonke, uzong understand mina. The way ngingakhona akhulume nami ngelanguage engiyi-understand if uNkulunkulu ufune ngize ngiba ngiyakholwa kuye ngibe western nazi, then it's a problem. Then that God is not for me. You understand?
Yeah.
UNkulunkulu ufuneka understand my culture and my religion.
Sure.
You understand?
Yeah.
I understand who I am.
Yeah.
You understand? So that because you will never be used by God if you are not who you are. I promise you.
Yeah.
The person that you wake up saying, Umbon, uNkulunkulu right there.
Prophet, I you speak so powerfully now and with so much conviction, but we know that it didn't start here.
Yeah.
So there is a part of you, you can correct me if I'm wrong,
okay.
There's a part of your life where you were operating in darkness, or was it Satanism? Which one was it? And can you just take me through that part of your life?
It's a part of my life that I really find it very difficult sometimes to talk about it.
Yeah.
Because people can misunderstand you.
Okay.
Sometimes when you talk about this. I started to have power when I was 12 years.
Mm-hmm.
When I was 14 years, I remember God gave me tongues. To kill someone.
God gave you tongues. Is it an instruction you're saying?
Yeah, God gave me tongues. God said, Nancy language was irritated and someone will die. If you want to curse someone, if you want to kill someone, this is a language that you must speak.
So through words only?
Through words only.
No action, no ends. Without
using anything.
No force, no weapon.
Nothing.
Okay.
I remember one day, and angisa mzimkhulu khona ndawo kuthiwa kusemajalidini ngangihamba nomalume wami then this guy they had an issue nomalume for whatever reason then wambetha and I was very angry and as an approacha yena I began to say something that I can't say it now then the guy fall down waqhuzula and the spirit said if you don't reverse it within 5 minutes, the man will die. Now, I made so many mistakes as a young man because of money, because of pressure,
temptation.
Mostly because of money.
Okay.
If I had to be honest to myself, because xa kumntu owasebhizana uthi look ngifuna i-position ethile kha wenze someone agule xa ndiya kwi-interview nantsi 50,000 and i-cash and I've never seen 50,000.
Yeah. Understand?
So any woman will want you know you meet new friends and all these friends bakwe big spaces and everything.
My decision makers.
And they come to you and say, I want this tender. This is 600,000. Make someone disappear. They've recognized. Remember, and
it's an open door policy. About whom we have great conversations with and whom we can be informed from and learn from. Thank you for your time.
God bless you.
Thank you, guys. We'll see you in the next episode.